Sierra Space's Dream Chaser is experiencing more delays, and its promising future is starting to look less bright. These challenges put Dream Chaser at a disadvantage, especially as SpaceX's Dragon continues to lead. This year, we're seeing a bigger disparity than ever before. What's causing this decline? And could Dream Chaser end up like Boeing's Starliner? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Dream Chaser has long been one of the most highly anticipated spacecraft in the industry. With its stylish spacecraft design and advanced technology, Dream Chaser marks a significant departure from the typical capsule spacecraft. Many consider it a potential competitor to renowned vehicles like Boeing's Starliner and SpaceX's Dragon. Even after years of anticipation and work, Dream Chaser still hasn't made its maiden flight. According to recent reports, this situation appears to be here for a while. Dana Weigel, ISS program manager, recently shared an update on Dream Chaser's current performance at X. On average, it takes 8 to 10 years to prepare and launch a spacecraft. We still need to complete several safety reviews, and we're currently updating both of our schedules to see how things are progressing. Sierra is working on it, so I need to wait for their response. I'm trying to figure out how they plan to handle some of the work, but we're excited to see it fly, as you know. It's helpful for us to have different capabilities in terms of our ports and logistics. We'll be ready for them when they're ready to fly. Despite NASA's support, Weigel's comments indicate the agency is unsure when Dream Chaser will be ready for launch. Now that we're in the second half of 2025, it seems increasingly unlikely that Dream Chaser will fly before the end of the year. One reason for this uncertainty is the condition of Vulcan Centaur rocket, which Dream Chaser requires for its launch. Based on this latest information, Vulcan is scheduled to launch on USSF Mission 106 on August 12th. This mission was previously delayed because Vulcan encountered some development issues. Now, this mission is a top priority because it's crucial to achieving National Security Launch Certification. So, Dream Chaser is still waiting. This highlights the ongoing scheduling conflict between Dream Chaser and Vulcan Centaur. While Vulcan is ready, Dream Chaser still has several tests to complete. While Dream Chaser is progressing, Vulcan's limited availability and long mission schedule have further delayed its launch. If USSF 106 successfully launches, Vulcan will likely continue with other delayed missions within the National Security Space Launch Program. If that mission is unsuccessful, the wait will be even longer. If Vulcan encounters further problems, it may not fly again this year. However, not all delays are due to external factors. As Dana Weigel noted, Dream Chaser still has challenges to overcome. He acknowledged that the Sierra space team is working very hard, but emphasized that creating a new spacecraft is extremely challenging. One of the biggest challenges is securing software certification, which is crucial for flight safety and successful mission completion. Software issues are typically more difficult to find and fix than mechanical ones. They require extensive testing and careful inspection before the spacecraft is cleared for flight again. This situation is similar to that of Boeing Starliner, although it falls into a different technical field. Starliner experienced several hardware and performance issues, such as thruster issues and a helium leak. Dream Chaser has performed quite well in testing its physical systems, but still faces serious software challenges. These issues could also impact its timely readiness. Thus, Dream Chaser will go another year without a launch. This delay is concerning because there is less time left for its crucial involvement in ISS operations. The ISS is rapidly approaching the end of its useful life. Any new spacecraft that wants to assist the ISS would need to launch quickly to make a difference. Missing this opportunity not only makes Dream Chaser less important, but also eliminates the CRS's chance of being part of a significant spaceflight. This leads us to compare it to Boeing Starliner. Both spacecraft were intended to compete with SpaceX's Dragon, but neither has made a significant impact. Dream Chaser still has potential and appears to have had fewer flight test issues than Starliner. However, its long delays put it on the same path. Still, Dream Chaser has some reasons to be optimistic. Its testing history is solid, and its new design continues to garner support from NASA and the broader aerospace community. If Sierra Space can resolve some of the recent issues, particularly with its software, their spacecraft could still be a reliable and robust spacecraft. What do you think? Will Dream Chaser have the same uncertain future as Starliner? Let us know by commenting yes or no below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. we'll keep you updated on SpaceX's incredible journey and the changes taking place in space exploration. What we've just discussed is just the beginning. Dream Chaser has many more missions planned for the future. Each mission marks a significant step forward in the development of this particular spacecraft program. After creating their first prototype called Tenacity, Sierra Space is now working on a second cargo prototype called Reverence. This second vehicle is expected to launch alongside the mission following Tenacity, likely around 2027. After these two cargo versions, the base version of Dream Chaser is expected to arrive next. This new crew prototype is expected to be ready in 2027 and is designed to assist missions to the ISS.
This timeline demonstrates the importance of the success of the first mission. It represents a significant technological milestone and a crucial step for future projects. However, the ISS isn't Dream Chaser's only goal. Sierra Space is developing a large inflatable habitat called the Living Habitat. This habitat is intended to support long-duration missions in low Earth orbit and beyond. It's unclear whether Sierra Space will continue its partnership with Blue Origin on the Orbital Reef Space Station project or choose its own path. Whatever happens next, Sierra Space will continue to use external companies for launches, as it currently lacks its own rockets. In this situation, the Dream Chaser spacecraft is crucial in helping Sierra Space reduce its reliance on other cargo or crew spacecraft. Dream Chaser still has many great possibilities. It has also received support from major organizations, such as NASA. NASA has more flight-tested vehicles than any other space agency. These vehicles can carry both cargo and crew on missions. By having more than one reliable option, NASA can reduce its reliance on a single provider. This gives it greater operational flexibility and ensures more successful missions. If Dream Chaser is successful, it will diversify the U.S. spacecraft fleet and make it more robust in competing with other countries' space programs. Besides scheduling issues, Dream Chaser has many advantages. Its design as a spaceship sets it apart from a typical capsule. Its wings can be folded during launch, allowing it to fit more comfortably inside the rocket. After completing its mission, Dream Chaser lands on a regular runway like a commercial airliner. This type of landing is more organized than a sea landing. This speeds up access to cargo and makes it easier to prepare the spacecraft for its next flight. Dream Chaser can carry as much payload as a typical spacecraft. Dream Chaser also offers more options with its attachable Shooting Star cargo module. Dream Chaser also has a deeper meaning. Inspired by the history of the space shuttle, Dream Chaser is closely linked to America's journey in space exploration. This connection creates a sense of inspiration and excitement that appeals to the public and spaceflight enthusiasts. To fully utilize these features, Dream Chaser needs to have a successful maiden flight. Taking that first step will lead to future projects, more applications, and increased independence for Sierra Space and the entire space industry. It's unclear whether they can achieve this soon. For now, we'll have to wait a little longer to see. Currently, Dream Chaser is facing numerous issues, demonstrating just how resilient SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft is, especially this year. Since its launch in 2019, Dragon has been a reliable and dependable spacecraft for NASA and the U.S. space program.